society class you, you have your own engaging in dialogues, lead civil society programs, energetic, vibrant and active. This will lead to building Malaysia's future. I will go faster. Eh? Okay, a few success stories. So, I ni macam buat thesis lah. I'm like writing a thesis basically. Kalau I boleh buat PhD, this will be my PhD. InsyaAllah. A few success stories. Okay, bersih. Sensitif tak? Tak ada, mana ada sensitif. Especially dekat Australia, okey lah. Kalau dekat Malaysia, ada ramai yang belakang tu tunggu ambil gambar lah. Tapi here, even in Malaysia pun, for that matter, what is wrong? Is bersih calling for violence? Is bersih calling for no election, revolution? No, they are calling for what? Coalition for clean and fair elections. Something good. What is wrong with that? Kita memang perlukan a clean and fair election. Ini tidak, kita undi, kita rasa orang tu memang patut menang. Semua orang undi dia, tiba-tiba orang lain menang. It is a coalition of like-minded civil society organizations, unaffiliated to any political party. Initially, yes, it was affiliated to political party, but bersih tu they changed it. Now it's only civil society organizations. Dan objektif dia, push a thorough reform of the electoral process in Malaysia. And they call for 8 points, very clear messages. Yeah, the 8 points apa dia? Indelible aim, no dirty politics, no corruption, and some of it. So these are all very, very civilized rules or values that they are trying to portray, project. Okay. And what was the reaction of the people? What was the reaction of the people? Memang people associate this strongly with something good. They saw that there were irregularities. They saw that their right to vote tu, dia vote tapi somehow keputusan dia tak kena. Jadi, you rasa macam insulted. You feel insulted. Ya? Kenapalah proses ni dipotolah habis sampai in the end, the election process tu is apa dia panggil? Is affected. Ya? Keputusan pun kita tak pasti. Yet, in the end, these are the leaders of the country. So, I'm not saying that the GE13 results tu kita tak terima dan sebagainya. Walaupun ada pihak kata kita tak sepatutnya terima. Kita kena buat pilihan raya semula. Ada juga yang kata macam itu. Tapi berani tak pakai rakyat untuk terima. Belum tahu lagi kan? Daripada yang menang banyak. So, ini reaction. Bersih satu, bersih dua, bersih tiga. Hundreds of thousands of people. Kenapa orang turun? Orang tak dibayar, orang tak ini, tapi dia pun turun. Yeah? So, success of bersih. Arguably, they influence change to the election process, political landscape and election results of GE12 and GE13. Because people were more conscious. Dia orang lebih sedar. Dia orang lebih nampak. Yeah? Information dikeluarkan, dibagi tahu dan sebagainya. Facts were actually also shared with the general public. Yeah, people were more aware about the electoral process. Yeah? What apa dia dakwah yang sepatutnya kekal tapi tak kekal. I mean, people were more aware about it. When people became more aware, they became more empowered. Bila masuk dalam pilihan raya, sebenarnya dia memberi perubahan. Okay, so, but this is arguable. Someone may contest me later, tak apa, no problem. Okay, and they are able to mobilize the mass, domestic and also international. Bersih dua, over 60 NGOs endorsed. And they were joined by 30 international cities, including Melbourne, Sydney, Canberra, I'm not sure, and the rest. Okay, dalam bersih tiga, over 80 NGOs endorsed. And they were joined by 10 cities in Malaysia and more than 30 cities worldwide. I mean, this is tremendous. Yeah, memang it's being acknowledged by not just Malaysians, it's actually being acknowledged worldwide. Tak pernah berlaku dalam sejarah sampai macam ni sekali lah. Yeah, that they were able to actually garner support all over the world. So it's real, it's serious. And definitely ini yang menyebabkan antara sebab-sebab utama. There was great involvement of youth, the young generation. Okay? And they had creative campaigns. You all saw it. Yeah, dengan kuning, dengan baju, dengan lots of ways of actually getting the message across. Okay, another success story. gerakan masukkan IAC, of course lah. This is close to me. Give me time for this.
10 minutes.
Okay. Okay, gerakan masukkan IAC, dia pun coalition. And it was the biggest coalition at that point of time. Lebih daripada 80 NGO, tak pernah dalam sejarah Malaysia, 80 NGO and also political party for that matter. Union pun masuk. Sisters in Islam pun ada. Apa lagi? Semua ada. Semua setuju. The same objective, abolish ISA, bebaskan tahanan, yeah, release all detainees and close Kemunting Camp. Jadikan Kemunting Camp tu museum. Seperti Robben Island. No, Robben Island was actually transformed into a museum. That is what we should do. Jadi museum sebagai simbol kezaliman. So, these were also very clear objectives. Very clear. Orang senang nak associate. Orang kata, oh, nak lawan apa ni? ISA. Kenapa? Sebab zalim. Kenapa? Sebab tahan orang tak ada bicara. Tak boleh bela diri. Tak boleh ni. Keluarga merempat. Anak-anak gila. Simple cakap lah macam tu. I mean, really. Itu simpati memang dapat lah tu. Don't worry. 100%. Okay? Tapi, mind you, PGMI ada world view. Bukan main-main maknanya. We study, we strategize, we look at how we can make change, influence change. Sampai ke peringkat dunia, kita kata kita nak jadi people's movement, international level, fight against human rights violation. So we have extended our objective, not just ICA tapi sebenarnya human rights violation. Apa-apa penafian hak asasi manusia pun kita akan perjuangkan. Kita akan pastikan supaya ianya dilawan. Okay? So, bukan kerja macam orang kata apa, NGO biasa kan, buat lebih kurang je, tak. Actually, it was also serious. Eh? Okay. Types of campaign, very fast. Banyak types of campaign. I would like to just highlight a few yang very unique. For example, we actually had signature and postcard campaign. There was also a hunger strike that was done. Sampai ada yang pingsan. Hampir-hampir pingsan lah, kita tak kata mati, tapi pingsan. Okay. And then, we had roadshow arts and theatre. Cara seni, menggunakan seni, menggunakan teater untuk menyampaikan mesej kepada masyarakat, kepada rakyat. Roadshow talks. We also publish books. Simply put, kita tengok gambar saja lah, senang. Okay. We engage. This is Hairi Jamaluddin, by the way. Kita pergi parlimen, kita suruh dia pakai badge Malaysia bebas dari ISA. Yeah. Dia tak pakai. Kita letak aja, media tangkap gambar. Besok keluar dalam Arka, dalam ni. KJ pun sokong anti-ISA. Okay, ini semua adalah taktik media. Itu pun kena belajar. Okay, ini Mukhris sekarang Menteri Besar Kedah. Gerakan pun sebenarnya support. Because among the gerakan members, ada yang ISA detainees. You know that? Okay. Ramai yang former ISA detainees at the same time. So, dia is support sebenarnya. Eh? Okay. And then there were book launches that we had. Many book launches, which are some of it. Yang ini, buku ni, Ia Sah Aniaya, this was the one that was published by GMI. Written by Haji Subki Latif, but was published by GMI. Mana GMI ni bukan sahaja NGO, tapi publish buku at the same time. Okay? And then, arts and theatre, I mentioned this just now. Theatre Bilik Sulit. And it went international recently, sampai ke UK, London, this theatre. Yeah, there were also CDs that was produced. Okay, and then students, mahasiswa against anti-ISA. Kesian kita tengok. Sebenarnya kalau student ni, selalunya polis jadikan mereka ni mangsa. Sebab dia nampak studentnya, dia garang dengan budak-budak. Unfortunately. Yeah. Tapi, I admire the students because they really withstand all the pressure. Eh? Okay, kemudian, ini biasa banyak buat. Kita banyak buatnya, peace march. And it's really peaceful. Kalau dia bagi kita buat, 1 hour, half an hour selesai. Tapi sebab dia kacau, 2 jam pun tak selesai. Okay? This was the biggest rally in 2009. It was estimated about 50,000 to 60,000 turn up. Tapi at the same time also, unfortunately, there were about 500 who were detained, who were arrested. The highest number of people that were arrested at that time. Okay? Tapi that is part of the struggle. Eh? Okay, so successes of GMI. Suhakam was always with GMI. They were always recommending that we need to abolish ISA. Suhakam ialah Suruhanjaya Hak Asasi Manusia, independent body. Biggest peaceful rally, kita berjaya untuk buat sampai 50,000 orang. Increase public awareness, increase international awareness. We also were awarded with certain things, Alhamdulillah. Yeah, Human Rights Award, Civil Society Award. And finally, the biggest success was ISA was abolished in 2013. Yeah, which is many people thought, masa kita mula dulu, Tuan saya tak payahlah minta abolish. Cukuplah kaji semula. I said no, kaji semula tak ada maknanya. The whole thing needs to be revamped and abolished. That is the only thing that we wanted. It was impossible. Yeah, many people had sacrificed themselves, tapi berjaya, Alhamdulillah. And all detainees were released for your precious. Semua telah dibebaskan.